Yes. Yes, I understand completely. We'll absolutely be able to help you out with that. I guarantee you. Oh, you must be talking about Yagami.
Bro, would that be like...
Absolutely. We appreciate any interest you might have. But it's
bro, why
just,
why the game look so crisp?
Wow, you know, must be so nice to be a rock star, right, Sari-chan?
Gendala, Sari speaking. Yes, Yagami is currently employed by our firm.
Alrighty guys, I'm gonna play the judgement, so I'll talk to you guys later.
All day.
The more you can win. Gotta play it on the speaker,
Yagami
bro.
Sensei.
Later.
Hey, throw me a bone. I never would have won without a hand from these two.
Of course you wouldn't have. 99% of these cases end up in convictions. It makes an acquittal a big deal. Even if it was just luck. Talk about a lawyer being a hero. Makes even a former gangster look good.
Guess so.
Wipe that grin off your face. You think you're better than us?
I'm no saint.
Shh. Could have fooled me. You know, you're not gonna win all of them. Trust me, pal. My record's not... Are you listening?
Of course. I get the message.
Hmm. Well, Shintani's available right now. Yeah, you bet. He's more experienced.
Are you hearing that?
No.
Now I'm getting tossed your goddamn leftovers.
Shut up, man.
Okay, and you're sure?
He's as skilled as they come, trust me. That is. Haven't you heard 99.9% of criminal court cases end with the defendant behind bars? Pretty ridiculous, huh? Right? What? Well, you still want Yagami, though.
Man, I am so done.
Hey, can it?
Bro, kind of a chat status.
Yes. Yes. And you're absolutely sure. I understand. I'll tell him.
Who was that?
Another call for Yagami-sensei.
Big whoop.
But the client is... Shinpei Okubo.
Huh?
Not sure I believe that. Okubo's a free man now.
Not anymore. He's been arrested for murder.
Come on. We already proved he was innocent, right?
It's a new case. He's being processed right now. What they told me is that... he stabbed his girlfriend Emmy to death. Set the apartment on fire.
Okubo would never do that. Stabbing Emmy-chan. I just don't understand it. Okubo. How could he? That day, my career as a lawyer died alongside Emmy-chan. Both murdered by Shinpei Okubo.
Cess Lord. Got the Akiyama look.
Come in, Kaito-san. Are you getting close yet?
Yep. Right by the Don Quixote. Heading your way now.
You just about see our man.
Oh, dude!
Yep, I got him. He doesn't have a clue, huh? You're getting good at this. Almost like a pro.
Wow, thanks. I always dreamed of being a professional stalker.
Not sure I'd call it that.
You gotta admit, this is crazy, though.
A detective tailing another detective? You only see that shit on TV.
Crazy or not, stay focused. Join up with you soon.
Okay.
Step aside, old man.
Piece of goddamn trash.
Hey, asshole, he said move!
Bro, you can't miss with the army, bro.
The fuck are you doing?
What? You wanna die, bitch? The hell is his problem?
What's going on back there, buddy?
Looks like I need to teach these punks a little lesson.
Need to? Didn't you tell me to keep my head down?
Hey, who you calling punks, you homeless piece of shit? Huh?
Sorry, Kaito. I'll see you soon, okay?
So much for being careful.
Get a load of him! Man, you seeing this shit? Okay, our boy's a movie star.
How's that? You're a damn joke. Let's do this thing!
Yes, dude. Man, got taught a lesson to the drip.
Who are you?
I'm all done. Kaito-san, where's our guy going?
On his way towards Pink Street. Crowd's thinning out. Get your ass over here.
Got it.
And make it quick. Any minute now, he's gonna figure out I'm shadowing him.
Really? I need more time.
Just get your ass over here. If we lose him, it's on you.
Well, that's just rude. Suspicious. Found him.
Finally. Thought you were never gonna catch up.
Sorry.
Time you pay all the rent you owe.
I just need a little longer, okay? Just one more week.
Another week? I am done warning you.
Yes, I assure you.
It better be.
Oh, that was close.
Call me.
don't even see him. Where is he at? Where's my dude? What the fudge? Where'd my guy go? Actually. Where is he though? Where is he? I actually don't know where he's at.
Kaito-san, he's heading for the Champion District.
Oh, great. We're never gonna find him in that maze.
Probably why he's going there. Thankfully, we can always follow him from above.
Yeah? Wanna break out the pigeon?
Just try to head him off, Kaito-san. And be ready.
On it.
Oh, and try not to get carried away. Can't afford to get that thing fixed again.
Yeah. Just don't lose him.
Left or right? Where are you going?
He just ducked into an empty lot, Kaito-san. Dead end. We follow him, we blow our cover.
What do you think he's doing in there?
Probably meeting someone he doesn't want to be seen with.
Makes sense. Pigeon's up. Can you see it?
Hold on. Hey.
Oh, a cat.
What the? There it is.
Hold on. I'll send the feed to your phone.
Nice flying, Kaito-san. Keep it steady. You been practicing?
Now's not a good time, Talk. Gotta concentrate. There's another guy in there with him.
So he is meeting someone. Hey, I know that guy. It's a bookie for horse races.
Trying to gamble his way to paying off debts, huh? Because that always works.
Yeah, well, if they came all the way out here just to meet, he must have the cash on him. We'll get what we need if we move now. You remember what we're doing here, right?
Collecting the debt that detective owes. Oh, I get it. This is our chance.
Just relax. Let me do my thing, okay?
You got it, Talk. Don't fuck it up.
Ha!
Nice night, huh, Detective? Huh? I hear the bookies in Kamurocho make some pretty good deals. You win 10% more, you lose 10% less. They make it sound so enticing. Maybe I should get in on it.
What the hell is this? Who are you?
Sit on another horse.
So they hired a thug to collect. Should I be impressed you found me?
A thug? Well, that's not very nice. You and I are in the same business.
You're a detective?
Afraid so. I hear you're pretty hard to get a hold of. That's why the people you owe came to me. Look, I know you have the money on you. You can't get out of this. Just do us both a favor and pay up. Don't put up a fight.
Well, you're right. I have the money. But look, I'll pay everything back after I win big on this next race. Just wait, okay?
Are you serious? I didn't track you down just so you could...
Maybe next time!
What? You gotta be kidding me. Kaito-san, he's making a run for it. You need to learn when to quit.
Shut up. I have it all figured out. I'll get the money!
Yeah.
Didn't you say you were a detective? What's your name?
I never said I'd field any questions, asshole. It's Yagami. Take a good look. Now do you believe me? So, let's be civil here. Just hand over the cash, okay? 150 grand sound good?
Back the fuck off! You running some kind of racket here? I'll sue you!
Oh yeah?
Bro, what a Chad.
You gonna sue? The fuck do you think you are? Huh?
Hold on, Kaito-san.
The hell? You're not a detective, asshole. You're fucking Yakuza.
Oh, yeah? Guess you know what'll happen if you don't pay up then.
Hey, ease up, Kaito-san. I'm sure he doesn't want to piss you off anymore.
I said all right.
Bro, Kaito's pissed, dude.
Listen here, asshole. I'm gonna sue your ass into the goddamn ground. You see this? You broke my fucking nose.
Don't be so melodramatic. I think we both know who threw the first punch.
No way I'm gonna let that slide. Just you watch. You'll see the court's gonna... Huh? But that's... a lawyer's badge. So you're not a detective.
And? You still want to sue? You know, you won't know what hit you.
What a goat.
Come, Rocho. No better place for a night out. A neon city. But the brighter the lights, the darker the shadows. The whole town's run by the toughest Yakuza family out there, the Tojo clan. And the deeper you dig, the more interesting things get. More dangerous, too. Take this burglary ring. Just a bunch of kids looking for kicks. Word is, they met on some sketchy website. Never even seen each other's faces. As for the cops, they can't catch a single one. The only thing anyone really cares about in Kamurocho these days, though, is the murders. Over 3 months, three Kansai Yakuza have turned up dead. Most think it's the Tojo clan making some kind of power move in the ongoing turf war.
This one's missing its eyes, too.
That's not the only thing, though. All three of them were missing their eyes. It's in one little corner of this city that I run a detective agency. I work alongside my partner, Kaito-san. Funny enough, he's ex-Tojo. And me? I'm Takayuki Yagami. Used to be a lawyer, but I put that life behind me 3 years ago. As for my badge, it's barely even a decoration at this point. Here, I'll scrounge up the rest for you later.
What about your cut?
I'll get it eventually. All of this goes to the client.
Gotcha.
Anyway, I'm gonna swing by Genda-sensei's place, see if he's got any work.
Don't hold your breath. For a lawyer's office, things are slow as shit over there.
You're aware they're one of our best clients, right?
Yeah, I know you used to work there and all. But don't show up empty-handed. Here, buy him some sweets or something. At least go through the motions.
So generous. My boy's all grown up.
Don't mention it, Dad. Now get going.
Bro, we don't got any records? What's going on here, though?
I hear they've got some extra fancy dorayaki at the Popo over on Tenkaichi Street. Even come in a box.
Huh?
Well, Genda-sensei's got a pretty big sweet tooth, if you get me.
Right. I'll go pick some up.
Bro, what's going on? Why is there so much stuff? What's there so much stuff? Dude, there's so much stuff.
my god. What the heck did I get? Oh my goodness. Sakura figures? Oh no, Michio figure? Oh, let's go. Bro. Let me see if I can put it in my office or something. Bro, why do I got the cats in here though? Just add all the cats next to each other if I can. There. All right, now let's get to the detective business.
ございました。
Are they?
Look, I've been after one of those things for days now, and you just bought the last fucking box. Can't stand for that, right, boys?
Bro, I'm gonna kick
him. Well, can't argue with that logic.
What was that, smartass?
Figure out a freaking wall jump.
Damn you!
Have you had enough?
Hey! Always getting into trouble.
Captain Hamura.
Talk here doesn't start shit without a real good reason. And that means it was you. You dumbasses jumped the wrong guy.
No.
You know this guy's like a son to the Matsugane patriarch, right? Know what I'm trying to say, asshole?
Hey, come on, Cap. Can't we just let it be?
No can do. This right here just became a matter of Matsugane family honor.
I'm sorry.
Kengo, you haven't met our buddy Tak here, have you? He's a guy you want to know. Hotshot detective type.
Right. It's good to meet you.
The boss paid his way through law school back in the day. Made him into a damn good attorney. Guy even managed to get a bona fide serial killer off the hook.
Seriously? Wow, that's incredible.
Right? Damn shame seeing talent like that go to waste.
Huh, totally!
Get this, though. The first thing that killer did when he got loose? Stabbed his girlfriend to death. Can you believe that?
Oh, damn.
Yep. Guy got the death penalty and everything. They get around to hanging his ass, Tak?
Not yet, no.
Oh, what the hell's taking him so long?
Here. This is the money from that detective. The rest is yours. I already took my cut.
Good. You're finally getting the hang of this whole debt collecting thing.
Yeah, thanks to you.
Anyway, how's Kaito?
Fine.
You mind asking him something? How long's he gonna stick around? Not wise to stay in town after you get kicked out of the family. But, I can look the other way since the boss likes you so much.
Speaking of, how's Matsugane-san doing?
None of your damn business, I'd say. Come on, let's go.
Get away, dude. Why are you following me? F it, come here.
You asked for it. Really, guys? Hey there, Saori-san. Look, Dorayaki. Extra fancy. Genda Law Office, where I used to work. Things haven't changed much these past 3 years.
Hello, Yagami-san.
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. You, getting situated?
Yes. Everyone here is just great.
So I hear you're good. Passed the bar with top marks and everything. How'd you end up in this dump and not in a bigger office, huh?
Huh? Well, you see, that's,
I hear you over there, Yagami.
Evening, Genda-sensei. Other than my real dad, there's two people I look up to like a father. Genda-sensei's one of those people. He gave me a job here, before I'd even gotten out of law school. Shintani-sensei out for the night?
I can't keep track of that boy. I'm sure you're happy, though. You don't have to deal with him.
Huh?
You two can't stand each other. You hate each other's guts. Be honest with me here.
Hold on now. Shintani's like a mentor to me. So, about that job you have.
If you really want that job, you're gonna have to get along. So show your senpai a little more respect.
Oh, Genda-sensei. I got you some dorayaki. Just sit right there. I'll grab you one. Huh? Sorry? Did you eat them all?
All but half. Hope you don't mind. Nope.
Say, Saori-san, got any work lined up for me?
Nope.
So, what are the chances you've got some work for me, Genda-sensei?
Work, huh? How long are you gonna keep doing this to yourself, Yagami? You know how dangerous this city is.
Wouldn't be many cases for me if Kamurocho was a safe place.
Uh-huh. Cases like collecting debt for the Yakuza?
Hey, better that than no work at all, am I right?
You call that detective work? You're practically a mercenary.
Fine by me. I was never too hung up on being a detective anyway.
Listen, Yagami.
Yeah?
You ever thought about becoming a lawyer again?
I haven't.
And why is that?
Take a good look at me, Genda-sensei.
Hmm?
These eyes aren't exactly the best judge of character. I think I made that clear 3 years ago. What use am I as a lawyer if I can't tell good from bad?
Knock it off, Yagami. Stop beating yourself up. What happened to Emmy was tragic, yes, but it wasn't your fault.
Doesn't matter whose fault it is. I never want to deal with something like that again. So, have any work for me? A guy's gotta stay busy, you know? Keeps me distracted from Emmy-chan and all that. It doesn't matter what you've got, just give me something.
How about a divorce case? I have some evidence that needs collecting. It'll be the usual deal. Stake out a love hotel, snap some photos, tail the guy, dig through some trash. You in?
I'm in. A job's a job.
I give up. I'll send you the details later. And next time, don't bring a gift, you hear? Doesn't feel right taking them from guys too broke to pay for.
Anything you say.
Genda Law Office. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yagami-san, that was Shintani-sensei.
Hmm?
Apparently, he wants your help gathering evidence for a murder.
Huh?
Since when are we working a murder case?
This is the first I've heard of it, too.
Go give Shintani a hand, Yagami. This blows that divorce I was gonna send you on out of the water. Been years since we had a murder case.
Shintani-sensei says he's waiting for you at Tender, that bar on Taihei Boulevard.
Tender? I'm there all the time.
Just making sure.
Bro. This is crazy, dude. I'm about to go solve a murder. Fight, dude.
Not a wise choice.
Yes.
And stay down.
Last time I was I do got a bit of funds.
Arigato gozaimasu.
You asked for it. And
Stay down. Got my first job here 20 years back.
Hey, Tuck. Shintani-sensei's in the back.
Great. We've got some business to talk.
Surprised to see me?
I'd be more surprised if I didn't.
Who's that, Tuck? A detective buddy?
Not exactly, Mari. This one's a client.
Won't be your client for long if you don't show up on time. You're late.
Come on, you called me here totally out of the blue. Chill out, maybe. Oh, and I'm getting a drink.
And I'm paying?
Let's call it a business expense.
Here's a familiar face. Kyohei Hamura, from the Matsugane family.
I ran into him earlier, actually. Ticket he's your client?
Yep, got hauled in earlier. They're charging him with murder.
Seriously?
Seriously. So, the Matsugane patriarch came to us for his defense. Genda-sensei is the go-to guy for all his legal problems, you know?
How'd you end up in the driver's seat then?
Genda-sensei gave him my card. Gotta say, not looking forward to defending a Yakuza.
Tough luck, I guess.
Anyway, you're coming with me to the station. Need to have a word with Hamura. You got way more Yakuza experience than me, after all.
Yeah, I suppose I do.
Let me give you a rundown of the case first. The victim was a Yakuza. A Kansai guy, part of the Kyori clan. They found his body tossed in a dumpster just about a week ago.
Hold on. This is...
The guy who got his eyes gouged out? Yep. Cops think Hamura's the one who did it.
Hell of a case, man.
This is the third Yakuza they've found like this. Fortunately, we're not dealing with a triple homicide here, so the media isn't swarming.
Hmm?
Hamura's got an alibi for the first two incidents. His third murder is the only one they're pinning on him.
So they won't admit the cases are connected?
No. Makes sense. Three bodies and not a single suspect isn't exactly giving the cops credibility. Guess they just want to get this case closed and move on, even if they have to force it through. And hey, the victim was Yakuza. Nobody really cares who hangs for it.
Has Hamura said anything to you?
Yeah. He told me he didn't do it. Claimed the cops were falsely accusing him.
So he insists he's innocent, huh? You think Hamura really killed him? Just curious.
I don't know. And I don't really care. If he says he's innocent, I gotta prove he's innocent. That's my job.
Why'd they come after Hamura, of all people?
Two reasons. First, the victim was a Kansai Yakuza from a group that's been making inroads in Kamurocho and picking fights with the Tojo clan along the way. Odds are this was a Tojo guy wanting to send a message. And as you know, Hamura fits the bill.
And the other reason?
Hamura and the victim were seen having a fight on the day of the crime.
I'm guessing there's security camera footage then. I think I know enough. We should get to the station.
You go on ahead. I got some calls to make first. Just take a cab there.
Will do.
Thank you.
Leaving already, Tuck?
What can I say? I'm a busy man.
Funny you should say that. Another customer of mine has a job for you. I'll tell you about it when you're not so swamped, okay?
Hey, I'm not about to pass up a paying gig.
Then come back when you and Shintani-sensei are done.
We just keep running into each other tonight, eh, Tuck? Why the long face?
Hamura-san. I'm Shintani from the Genda Law Office. The Matsugane family asked us to represent you.
Then I'm glad you said yes, Shintani-sensei. We're gonna get along real good. Just like my boss and Genda-sensei.
Right. Well, let's get started. I'll be taking point, while Yagami here will be doing the legwork to try and back up your claims.
No better guy to do it.
I'll do what I can.
So, they brought you in under suspicion of murder. Can you tell me more about that?
Huh? What do you want to know?
Whether or not you killed the guy.
Does it really matter? Your job's getting me out of this mess, regardless of the truth.
No. Because if I find out you actually did it...
You'll drop me?
Better. I'll make sure the prosecution puts you away for life.
This is bullshit! Just like you did that serial killer, huh?
Yagami?
All the evidence at the time pointed to Shinpei Okubo being innocent. That's why I chose to trust him.
But then, that Okubo guy... Well, he proved us all wrong. Murdered his girlfriend in cold blood.
Come on, Tuck. Let's be honest about what you were really focused on at the time. You wanted that precious acquittal so bad, you didn't even stop to think you were setting a murderer loose, right?
What happened to innocent until proven guilty?
Try saying that to Emi Terasawa's parents. That's why you quit, right? You couldn't face him.
You think,
sure.
We could maybe get back to the case?
Sure. Why not?
You good to go?
I'm fine. Keep going.
My apologies. Now, let's start with the victim. Toshiro Kume, 34 at his time of death. A member of the Kansai-based Kyore clan. Around 6 a.m. on the 4th of December, the police got a 110 call from someone who found his corpse in a pile of garbage.
I hear you and this Kume had some kind of argument before he died.
Yep.
Did the police say what evidence points to you being the killer? Do they have anything substantial?
Nope. Bastards are keeping their lips sealed. Ain't that right, Shintani-sensei?
Yes. At this point in the investigation, the cops won't tell me what they've got against you. Your words are the only thing we'll have till the trial.
Is what it is.
Anything else you want to ask, Yagami?
What do we have on the victim?
Toshiro Kume, 34. Run-of-the-mill Kyori grunt.
Was Kume alone when you ran into him? Hard to believe he'd take that kind of risk in hostile territory.
It was him and one more. Probably another Kure asshole. Don't know his name, though.
So there were two of them. How many of you?
I'd say there was probably five, including me.
You have an alibi? What time did they think Kume died?
Apparently between 2 and 3 in the morning. The cops were drilling me real hard about where I was around then.
And? Where were you?
At a sauna. A spot called Sauna Goten. Spent the night getting a steam.
But there's no proof you were actually there, huh? Well, otherwise you wouldn't be in here.
Pretty much. Someone should have seen something, though.
Who's the detective in charge of the case?
Kuroiwa, from organized crime. Shintani Sensei is probably real familiar with him.
I am. More so because he's one of those brutes with a badge. Pretty sure the Kure murders are his case.
I can't stand him. Guy doesn't give a rat's ass about Yakuza.
Where did you and Kume have your fight?
Out in front of a club, Amour, over on Supon Street. Me and a few Matsugane boys had a little run-in with a Kure guy. Turns out that was your boy, Kume.
And who started the fight?
Who do you think? I'm not gonna let some Kansai punk strut around like he owns the place. I'd already thrown a few drinks back at that point, too.
What time did this all go down?
Just past 9.
So what happened after you and Kume had your standoff? Went your separate ways?
Nah, he tried to split, but I had my boys grab him. Dragged him into a moor.
What?
I thought it was just a little scuffle, though. You're saying you abducted Kume on a crowded public street?
Yep. Moore is one of the family businesses. So I went in, kicked the customers out, and kicked the crap out of Kume. But I'm telling you, I didn't kill the guy. Just tossed him out the back door when I was done with him. I left right after, too. A few minutes before midnight.
Uh-huh. So you were seen dragging Kume into the club, and he was found in the morning with his eyes gouged out. I'd arrest you, too, if I was a cop. I think I've heard enough for now.
We'll get going, then.
Be crazy, bro.
Yagami, head over to Sauna Goten for me. See if Hamura's alibi holds water.
All right.
If we can prove he was there, we won't even have to go to trial. I'll give you a ring tomorrow for the report. Later.
Up.
Really, guys?
He's pissed, bro. He's pissed. What are you squaring up for? Come here. Is there any side mission?
Excuse me, you work here?
Yeah, come on in, friend.
Actually, I'm not a customer. Mind if I ask you a few questions?
Sure, what do you need?
I'm here about a murder. A Yakuza who had his eyes gouged out.
Oh, a detective came by for the same thing. Wanted to know if their suspect was with us the night of the incident. And you are a reporter?
Something like that, yeah. And this is Hamura, captain of the Matsugane family. Did he come in on the night of the crime?
I'll tell you the same thing I told the cops. I make it a point not to remember anyone specific, you know?
You get a lot of customers in and out, huh?
Up to the last train, at least. From there, it's only in till morning. You know how it is. People drop in, wait for the trains to start up again. Same as any other night.
Interesting. So everyone who comes in stays till morning, huh? And as long as I can prove Hamura was here, we'll have our alibi.
Oh yeah, the cops mentioned something kinda similar.
You guys don't have a security camera? Something we could check, see who was here?
We do, but it deletes all its footage every 3 days. Privacy, you know. It was already long gone by the time the cops came around.
Got it. Thanks. Sorry to bother you. Hey, you're out here pretty often, right? Did you see a Yakuza head into Sanoko-ten the night of December 3rd?
Why would I know that? You're crazy, mister.
Hey, you have a sec? I'm looking for info on a Yakuza who went to Sanoko-ten on the night of December 3rd.
You seriously expect me to remember something from that long ago? I'm trying to work here. Get lost!
Excuse me. I'm looking for info on a Yakuza who stopped by Sanoko-ten on the night of December 3rd. Did you see anything? This is the guy. Name's Hamura.
I can't say I know him. There's tons of Yakuza around here. Though, now that you mention it, I remember something about a host getting smacked in the face that night.
By a Yakuza?
Yep. Don't think he got hurt too bad, though. Pretty sure it happened right around midnight.
All this on the night of the incident.
But when I went to check things out, the Yakuza was long gone. The host was just standing there shouting. That help at all?
Any idea who the host was?
Nah. I mean, they all kind of have that pretty boy look. Doubt I'd be able to recognize him if he was standing right in front of me.
Does anyone else know about this?
I don't know.
Thanks for your help.
Yo.
You're still here? I thought you'd have left hours ago.
I was gonna, but I realized all I do at home is pass out. Did go for a drink, though.
Oh, now you're having another. You know that bottle's mine.
Well, Genda-sensei give you any work?
Yep. Probably thanks to the Dorayaki. He wants me to scrounge up some evidence for a murder trial.
You got this from Genda? I thought it was all about civil suits now. Criminals don't pay the bills, right?
Well, this one comes straight from Matsugane-san. Turns out, Hamura went and got himself arrested.
What the hell?
For one of those Kyore clan murders.
You mean that eye-gouging shit?
Mm-hmm. I just dropped by the jail to see him. He claims he's innocent, though.
Huh. Crazy.
Not interested? I can't say I blame you after what Hamura did. Booting you from the family was a low blow. If you want, I'll handle it solo.
Look, don't worry about it. I'm the one who fucked up, not him. Either way, we've got the case. Count me in.
Good. What's up, Shintani?
Morning, sunshine. I'm on Nakamichi Street.
Yeah, and?
You know Majore? Little cafe, killer coffee. Come here.
Another impromptu meeting?
Don't whine. I thought you liked keeping busy.
Hey, over here. Take a seat.
Right. Anyway, I asked around near Sauna Goten. Couldn't get anyone to back up Hamura's alibi, though.
All right. Good work.
So, what'd you call me out here for?
Something came up. Take a look at this. Cops released it to the media. It's the camera footage from a moor. Hamura and Kuma are both in here, clear as day.
Damn. Didn't realize the cops had their hands on this. This could be pretty bad.
Ready? I'm gonna play it. Kume's the poor bastard getting dragged into the club.
Explains why Kumi's buddy there is running for his life.
Yep. Got a name, too. Akira Murase. Another Kyore thug. Word is, he hasn't left Kamurocho after getting interrogated by the cops. By the look of things, there must be a Kyore hideout nearby.
Crazy how clear it all is. Hamura can't just talk his way out of this.
Yep. And there's more. Take a look at this. One hour later, everyone leaves, except for Hamura and Kume. Even the owner hightails it.
Wait, why would they stick around?
Who knows? Our pal Hamura never mentioned this part. Now, this happened around 10 p.m., meaning there was another 4 hours before Kume's suspected time of death. The question is, what were the two of them doing all that time?
Hamura said he threw Kume out of the club around midnight. After that, he left the club himself and went to the sauna.
Right. But I want to hear how it all went down from a different angle. That's where you come in, Yagami. You gotta talk to the guy in charge of Amor.
Back up a second.
Huh?
You're the lawyer here. I get that. You decide what kind of investigation we need for the trial. But don't tell me how to do my job.
Yeah, but aren't you gonna talk to him either way?
All the same, I'd appreciate it if you'd stop barking orders at me.
Freaking tell him off, dude. Now, give me that coffee. I want the cup. Oh, I'm full.
Arigatou gozaimashita.
Sorry, sir. I would have totally ate your coffee, too. Dang, dude. Y'all gonna see the experience. Cat. Where's the cat? I'm not leaving without the cat, so...
Who are you? You need something?
Actually, I was wondering if you have a minute to talk.
About?
About December 3rd.
Oh, I had that day off, man. If anyone's gonna know, it's our manager. He doesn't come in till nighttime, though.
The manager, huh? This him?
Oh, it is.
What's his name?
Aragaki.
Think you could get in touch with him for me? We need to have a chat.
I could try. Hold on. I knew this was gonna happen. He never has his phone on during the day.
Dude, this is the voice actor for Spider-Man.
You mean in Kamurocho?
Yep, usually.
Alright, I'll go take a look around.
If you don't mind me asking, how? You're just gonna walk the whole city?
No, I have a plan. Someone I can use to help me find him. With the name and photo, it shouldn't be much of a problem.
If you say so, man. Good luck.
Thanks for the help.
Actually, I think we'll stop here.